with the best automotive information for your vehicle. And now your hosts, Matt Allen and Dave Riccio.
Well, good morning, everyone, and welcome to Bumper Radio. I am Dave Riccio here along with Matt Allen, and together we are your KTAR car guys, heard every Saturday from 11 to noon. At Bumper to Bumper Radio, we're helping you, the motoring public, have a better overall car experience. So if you got car questions, we've got car answers, and we encourage you to give us a call at 602-277-5827, 602-277-KTAR. And for the shy types, you can text us at 411-923. And I'm a little bit short of breath because I just ran down the hall to get to this microphone.
Carrie's like, boys, you're on. We're like, what?
So anyway, we brought in Frank Lewitz from Desert Car Care. That's at Chandler and Dobson, one of the great shops at Bumper to Bumper Radio. Great to have you with us, Frank.
Awesome. Great to be here, guys. Good morning to you.
Always awesome to see you. And, you know, today on the Bumper to Bumper Roadmap, course, fact or fiction, we'll come up with something here.
We got three of us, so we can actually do a true fact or fiction. where we can debate that back and forth between the besides the two of us. Talking about it.
A little bit of open phones and vibrations. Vibrations are always an issue. You know how many cars I get in with customers and I drive them around and they're taking me for a drive for some other thing going on, like a noise, and I'm like, do you notice that vibration? No,
you just made a face like there's a stink in the room, like the vibration is so bad. Or I mean, the difference between people come in and they I want to get an alignment because I've got a vibration.
Ever heard that, Frank?
All the time. And then when you look, the biggest thing is they're going elsewhere, and they've said, hey, wait a minute, you need an alignment because of that vibration, but that is not the case. Alignments don't square that away.
Not necessarily.
So let's just make a little alignment is getting the wheels all going down the road the same direction. Exactly the same direction.
Mm-hmm. It's like the balance. It's like the chiropractor.
Yes.
Straighten me out.
Right.
Vibrations don't come from alignment, wheel alignment. Vibrations come from sometimes tire balance is the issue, and they come for a whole lot of different reasons too, but most commonly people relate to the tire vibration. When you're going on the freeway 65 miles an hour and your hand's just jiggling in front of you, you know? It's like the shake weight.
Well, and technically a brake squeak is nothing but a vibration. I mean, it's a very rapid vibration making a noise. So we can have things vibrating. We can have a vibration that causes a noise. I mean, we had a car we worked on the other day. You know, a couple of weeks ago, you remember Dave was talking about this weird noise and this strange noise, and it just took forever to find it. And it was the air filter box was loose. You know what I'm talking about, Frank? The screws that go in and, you know, how many hundred times has that air filter been checked? And that was loose. Well, we worked on a car, and we left a little bracket just not quite tight all the way. Just it's something that it wouldn't hurt anything on the car. I mean, there's three bolts that hold down this little plastic shield. Well, one of them didn't get it tightened down all the way. And the lady came back. She goes, my car has a noise it didn't have before. Man, you could barely hear it. I'm like, wow. But she was right. We looked around. It took us 20 minutes or so driving, listening. Find that one little bolt just needed another quarter of a turn to seat it. But that little tiny, it's really a vibration. That's what most people are talking about when they're talking about a vibration. I mean, most of the time they come in, when they come into your shop, Frank, what are they saying? My steering wheel shakes or?
Well, hopefully they're saying the right thing. And I think you guys do a great job talking about that interview process up front. You know, if you've got a noise vibration, it is important to say, hey, also I've got this sort of tapping or this, rolling pitch type noise, the more information we get. I wanted to bring up something because it's interesting, technology-wise, we've come a long way from the stethoscope regarding noises and possible vibrations. There's a new test device out that actually measures.
iPhone can do it.
iPhone can measure. Yeah, there you go. What is that device? I don't have it in the garage,
it's not that new.
NWS or something?
There's NVH, noise and vibration harshness analyzer.
Right.
I think the manufacturers have them, the dealerships have them, but every time I've gone to ask them about it, they usually have to unpilot underneath all the dust because they've
never used it.
I use a tool that's worked for the last 20 years since I've been in the business. It's called a buttometer.
Yeah.
There you go. Sit in there and feel it.
Yeah. But there are some devices that can listen and tell you if it's a plastic on plastic or a metal against plastic or what the materials are. There is some of that. I've got some really super expensive headphones that have a listening device on them, you can hear like, and I'm a, the number's not far off, but you can hear a pressure leak of like a quarter pound over a day. Mm. You can hear just that very little air leak. You can.
We just used, we have the remote microphone, the wireless, and we had this sort of, yeah, the chassis ears. And again, that's one of those devices that may sit a little bit, but boy, when you need to use that in the garage. So we had this rear bearing type noise, and we couldn't decipher, was it that outer bearing or was it the guts to the rear differential? And with that listening device, you can hear it easily.
So for the listeners, what that is, there's a thing called chassis ears. And I think the kit maybe comes with six or eight little boxes, depending on which box you buy or which kit you get. So each one of those little boxes has a – you have to have a battery in it. It's got a strap or something to strap it to the car to hold it. But then there's a wire with a clip. And then you can go around. You can put maybe one clip on the left wheel bearing trailing arm or the one on the right, put one on the motor mount. Just pick wherever you think this noise might be coming from and then go drive the car. And then you've got the
– You just change channels.
Yeah, you've got the mothership, the switch box in the car. So when you're driving, you say, let's listen to the right rear. Let's compare it to the left rear. So sometimes we don't really know – can't say that the noise itself is bad. We have to have something to compare it to, left to right. Hopefully they're not both bad.
you drive a Ford Explorer, they probably are.
Which ones? They're one of the more difficult. You're really good at finding them, Dave. I love vibration.
You know, if there's a noise or a vibration, I always get in the car with the customer, just go drive it. So I'm fixing the right noise, the right vibration, because what I hear and what they hear could be something totally different. That's been there like that since the beginning. I'm like, really? You can live with that noise?
Yeah, you stand it. Then there's those noises like, we had a Subaru yesterday. Gosh, we drove it 14, 15 miles for the life. I mean, we thought we kind of heard something, but this girl keeps her car clean. Their glove box wasn't full of trash. There wasn't a bunch of junk in the trunk and golf clubs and all this stuff. The car was clean, only 40,000 miles, but for the life of us, we couldn't figure out or even hear. So she might just be sensitive. Certain people hear at different frequencies. Getting for a test drive and going, how many times do we fix the wrong noise?
Yeah, we get that. I mean, it happens.
Frank?
It happens, yeah. I mean, that's why it's important, I think, initially, to have a technician actually get in the vehicle and confirm. And maybe confirm that once or twice. We've had occasions where we're driving in the morning and we just couldn't pinpoint it. And, you know, it's like going to the doctor. Everyone say?
Yeah, you don't feel
you guys listening know. Oh, I took it in. They couldn't find it. It's like that mystery. So let's have the car for a few days. You know, we put them in a rental. And because it's really important. Some of these noises or vibrations can get away from you. They can be a safety issue.
Well, yeah, they can certainly develop into one. And then it's hard. Like I had a guy, we balanced the tires. But, I mean, we know they were out of balance. We checked them. We knew for sure. We can verify it. We spun them first. But I wasn't able to go out and verify. It's 4 o'clock. I can't go get on the freeway at 4 o'clock.
Not happening.
I mean, it's just not happening. So, unfortunately, I tell him, I said, we're confident that the tires are now in balance. I just can't confirm that there's not something else because that's just where we started.
We talk about the buttometer and the seat of the pants feel. Frank, you know that you can have 10 technicians. Not every one of them has a seat of the pants feel, right? They'll go drive the car around the block. They come back. I can't tell what it is. You go drive around the block. You're like, put U-joints in it. You know, work with that guy,
happen.
Right? You know,
it can happen.
Well, it's a level of experience. And sometimes I think we put undue pressure on ourselves a lot. Like we want to get your car back to you, where we ourselves at the shop need to slow it down a little bit. And the consumers need to understand, you know, sometimes it's not always going to get done in the same day.
I wish you could just plug into it and it would tell you what the noise is.
I mean, they don't have that?
Yeah. No. Yeah. After a while, though,
these advertisements, though, that you never have to pay the mechanic again.
No.
Plug it in.
But after a while, you develop a photographic memory for the noises. So I guess it wouldn't be
Well, worse yet, you're out with your family and you smell or hear something. You're like, wait a minute. That's a noise coming from that Crown Vic.
Right.
That's that water pump.
I do the same thing. I'm like, I hear this. I'm like, somebody around here driving here needs brakes because they're squeaking. I'm always diagnosing cars as I'm.
Oh, in the parking lot, somebody gets out of the car and you kind of give them a little scowl. You're like, man, you got to get that radiator leak fixed bad. Because you can smell it from a block away.
Yeah. Well, and I suggest too, Pascal brought this up on one of the shows before, switch cars with your spouse. I mean, he jumps in his wife's car, and he's like, holy moly, how what is going on here? She's like, oh, I just thought that was normal. You know? So, I mean, it's to your point, Dave, you might jump in a customer's car, and, I mean, I drop it in gear, and boom, you hear the motor mount slam, and you're like, don't you hear that? They're like,
no.
Yeah, that's been doing that a couple years. I'm like, what? So, 602-277-5827, 602-277-KTAR. That's how you call us. That's the only way for we can answer your questions. And it doesn't have to be a shake, a rattle, a vibration, anything like that. It's whatever you want to talk about your car, whatever ails you. Give us a call again, 602-277-5827. And for the shy type that like to text, you can do that at 411-923. You're listening to Matt and Dave, your KTR Car Guys, with special guest Frank from Desert Car Care Chandler. We'll be right back.
Hi, I'm Kaylee O'Kelly, and it's great to be back on ABC 15 Mornings. I'm thrilled to help get your day started with the latest news, traffic, and most accurate forecasts. I'll see you every weekday on ABC 15 Mornings, 4:30 to 7 a.m.
Gas or diesel, foreign or domestic. If your car hurts, take it to Kurtz.
That's our closing line, Pops.
I know, Jeff. Just reinforcing that we're full-service auto repair.
At Kurtz Auto Repair, we do it all, including diesel. We have the passion, training, equipment, and expertise for diesel. Our techs are ASC certified for diesel and advanced diesel diagnostics. Toy hauling, horse trailering, off-roading, or work trucking, we've got you covered.
Gas or diesel, foreign or domestic, if your car hurts, take it to Kurtz. Check us out at mycarhurts.com.
I'm picking up good vibrations. She's giving me the excitations. I'm picking up
Welcome back to Bumper to Bumper Radio. I am Dave Riccio here along with Matt Allen. Together we are KTR Car Guys, and we've got Frank Lutz in with us from Desert Car Care, helping us help you with your car. And the phone calls are starting to roll in at 602-277-5827, 602-277-KTAR. We're talking a bit about vibrations, and a lot of people have vibrations going on. They just think it's normal. You don't have to live with those vibrations if you don't want to, unless it's kind of like a nice pulsating massage on your lower back. It helps, something like that. But they're actually not good for the car. You can actually shake things apart underneath your engine compartment. So you don't necessarily want to just live with a vibration. You kind of want to get it checked out. So if you're thinking you got something like that going on, don't hesitate to give us a call. If you got a window regulator that keeps going out, or we got a text from a guy here, he's got a Toyota Tacoma and the AC fuse keeps blowing, we can help you with any and all that at 602 277-5827, 602-277-KTAR. Do you live with vibrations in your car, Matt?
Occasionally I do, and they drive me nuts, but it's a lot of time it's like the cobbler's kids.
Yeah.
You know, the shoes. Like I had Ludwig's car at the shop broken down last week, which was funny because he thought he had a brake problem as he's coming to a stop. This is your 17-year-old kid. He's like, Uncle Matt, my car, there's something wrong with the brakes. And so I said, well, just be careful driving home where you're in. I go out to test drive with him. Well, he's got a surging problem. So as he's coming to the stop, he's got his foot on the brake, but the car is wanting to rev to 1500. Nothing wrong with the brakes. But I don't know how I got off on that sidetrack. But the point of that was, yeah, I have to live with them because to me, a customer's car takes a priority over my car unless I'm going to break down.
I know.
You know,
my wife says, can you take my car in the shop for an oil change? No, honey, just take it to the dealer. Not really.
Go to the car wash, but just don't get any of the
don't
other
them,
stuff.
Don't let them sell you anything.
Well, before we dig in, Frank, let's talk a little bit about the network and the whole purpose of us being here. Is bumpertobumperradio.com is more than just a website. Bumper to Bumper Radio is this show, and it's Dave and I every Saturday helping you. Help just figure out, we don't necessarily want to tell you how to fix your car if you're a do-it-yourselfer, we're glad to help you, but we want to help you have a better experience. So whether that's gathering good information and how to talk to the service advisor, but the core of Bumper to Bumper Radio is the .com part, and that's the shops that Dave and I endorse blanketly throughout the valley, and they're good guys, just like Frank sitting here with his daughter Natalie, who's not going to talk much. She should at least have her headphones on so she can hear the other half. But Frank, so tell us a little bit about Desert Car Care and your location. You've been part of the group now since we started almost 8 years ago.
Yeah, I want to say first off, thanks for having me. It's an honor to be in the studio with you guys. And again, congratulations, 7 years on the radio. You guys rock. Our garage has been a part of Bumper to Bumper with a family of great garage owners and collision shops since inception, and we're proud to be a part of that network. Our garage has been in business since 2004 down on Chandler and Dobson. We're small business of the year, best places to work, ranking Arizona, top 10. In fact, Matt and I, and I think Dave, we all go back and forth on that list.
Yeah, but that list. Sure.
Look, the bottom line is forget the accolades. Our business is really about the people, both front and back counter, you know, the culture that we have in the garage. And, you know, you mentioned earlier, first segment, that, you know, once in a while we have to be accountable. I think that's what separates the good guys and the bad guys and the good guys and the bad girls.
Hey,
you know, I mean, and that's the key. And I think that's what this network's about. That's what this show is about. And people can appreciate that is when you own what you do.
Well, yeah. Hey, I know what crow tastes like. Occasionally, I eat a plate of crow.
It happens.
Because we screw up. You know what I mean? But it's anybody can do a good job when things are going well. But when mm-hmm. things go bad, you know, hey, and it happens. We're going to screw up when we work on a car. But these shops, and I know, Frank, you're involved. We got some phone calls we got to get to. These phones are going crazy. But Frank's in the community. Frank's part of that Chandler community. I'm part of the Central Phoenix community. I mean, we're participating. We're helping out with charity. We're sponsoring the Little League teams. You're going to see us in the grocery store. Our kids all go to school together. I mean, I'm not talking about the network, but your kids are going to school with somebody that's got kids in this radio show or on this Bumper to Bumper program.
I mean, so I think that's what people deserve, right? You know, the service side, fixing cars is fixing cars, but I think at the end of the day, it's still a service. I mean, if you go back to inception of time, if you think about it, those that were successful and owned what they did, they provided a service. It was mm-hmm. like you said, you know, your kids are going to school together and that sort of thing.
Yep.
So, yeah, it's good stuff.
Let's get after these phone calls, Dave. What do you want to do?
Let's go with Steve in Chandler. He's got a 2009 Chevrolet Silverado. How can we help you, Steve? You are on Bumper to Bumper Radio.
Yeah, so I'm pretty handy, but I'm nervous about this one. I've got a indicator on my dash telling me service four-wheel drive. It'll pop up. And then I'll be like, oh, no, I got to take care of that. I'm going to, you know, everything's going to fall apart. And then it's gone. And I haven't been able to find a solid answer online.
You know, Steve, I think you should just get a different car altogether. That's my first. But if I could just tell you what kind of the pattern is for that light. That service four-wheel drive is like the check engine light, but the check engine light for the transfer case or the four-wheel drive. And real commonly on those Chevrolets, there's an electric motor down on the transfer case that operates the transfer case. And there's switches up on the dash to put it in four-wheel drive. And the computer is generally recognizing some sort of error in communication between those two and saying there's an issue with it. So, you know, when we scan a vehicle, we can scan the powertrain control module. That's mostly what people plug into. That's what they plug into at Acme Auto Parts, okay? But, you know, if you go to the Acme Auto Parts, they can't scan a lot of times a transfer case control module. That's where the code or the clue is going to be as to what's going on. So you're going to need to scan that and see what's going on. Sometimes it's a switch up on the dash. Sometimes it's the actual module that controls the transfer case. Sometimes it's that electric motor. And sometimes there's a mechanical fault within that transfer case. That's all the hard work that has to happen to get you the answer what you're looking for.
And you know, I caught it at barely at the very end, and I don't know if you heard Davey said, I haven't been able to find anything online.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm surprised because it's a common enough problem. But, man, you go online, you can really run yourself down a rat hole.
Oh, yeah.
And buy a lot of expensive
Google parts. Gnostics.
And the thing is that plug-in to check the transmission control module or the body control module or, you know, none of these cars, some of them have 9 different modules, 10, whatever. It's not a different plug-in. It's just the ability of your tool. So some people might say, oh, well, they have the tool. Well, they have the tool that can read the one module.
Mm-hmm.
You have to have the tool that can get in and read all the modules and communicate.
And then what are you looking at, right? You got to be able to decipher that data. And yeah. I think that's where the biggest problems can
biggest
be.
One comes in.
Right, and that's the way we're going to diagnose that thing. So if we did have a bad electric motor down there on the transfer case, we're actually going to look at the voltage on it. You know, we're going to read that in the data. The code is just a code. It's like, hey, kind of puts us in the area. But it doesn't really diagnose it.
It's the zip code of where the letter needs to go, but you still need the home address and the name before that piece of mail is going to make it.
Yeah.
So that's kind of the analogy that I like.
And I think that comes up so much is that people, you know, I do get the comment, well, you just plug into it and it just tells you what's going wrong with the car. Hey, listen, the later the model of the car, the more accurate that whole plug-in situation is. But as far as, you know, sometimes it doesn't tell you anything. So we worked on a car here recently where they went to the dealership. The dealership said, no, can't figure it out. And then they went to another shop. Another shop said, can't figure it out. And it came to us, and we plugged into it, and, of course, there's no information there. But we literally had to go drive the car for 30 miles with two technicians, one reading the matrix scanner data and looking for stuff that looks weird, and then someone driving the car. And that's how you figure it out. But the computer didn't tell us anything.
Well, but I want to correct what you said. You said there was no information there. There was tons of information, but there was no just quick answer.
Correct.
You know, the doctor, when they've got you hooked up to the EKG and all this stuff, and there's all these lines and squiggly things, the only one that we all really know is the one that's flat. And by that time, you don't know what's going on. But the rest of those lines, they don't tell you anything. You have to know what you're looking at. You have to be able to go and find, and when the car doesn't have a check engine light or it has an intermittent problem like with this Chancellor case, those are the most difficult. When the car's broken, it's easier to fix. I mean,
oh yeah, when it comes in it's broken, yeah. But you know, if you think about it anymore, how often are cars like breaking down on the side of the road? Anymore, it's got some little weird idiosyncrasy or some lights and bells and chimes are going off, things like that. But isn't it like the old days? I don't see cars towed in as much as I used to. In the old days, it was a regular thing. Radiator hose popped off, water pump went out, this happened, that happened. I think we're getting better at servicing them as well. So anyhow, when we come back, we can help you with anything on your car. And if we can't, we'll make something up at 602-277-5827. 602-277-KTR. You're listening to Matt and Dave, your KTR Car Guys, on Bumper to Bumper Radio.
Honesty and integrity, it's the only option. Hi, Spencer Doucet for H&I Automotive. H is for honesty, and I is for integrity. We built our business on these two principles. We opened our first shop in Mesa in 2009, and with the support from our loyal customers, we've now grown to a second, state-of-the-art location in Gilbert. Two locations, same principles. Quality service at a great value, backed by an industry-leading 60-month, 60,000-mile parts and labor warranty. Check us out at hndiautomotive.com.
This summer, get $29 rounds each Wednesday at the short course at Mountain Shadows. Bunker to Bunker is teaming up with the historic Par 3 course to offer special seasonal rates. Plus, get a free drink and exclusive bounce back offer if you mention the show when booking your tee time or use the code BUNKER to reserve your round online. Call 480-624-5432 or visit mountainshadows.com. That's mountainshadows.com.
Hi, I'm Dave Riccio, owner of Tri-City Transmission. While you may have come to know us for being a transmission expert, what you may not know is that our customers regularly ask us why we don't perform repairs to the rest of the vehicle. You guys are so great. Why work on just the transmission? Well, the request became hard to ignore, and 3 years ago, we began to build an infrastructure to perform general automotive repair. We weren't going to do general repair if we couldn't be great at it. So in 2013, we began the soft opening of Tri-City Auto Repair on Smith Road. We brought on ASC Master Technicians to work side-by-side with our Master Transmission Technicians. The combination of the best in both of these trades has created a synergy that allows us not only to fix your transmission, but to service and repair your whole car, and to do it well. Let's face it, the modern car has become so integrated. We believe all of our expert knowledge puts us ahead of the curve. Find us at tricitytransmission.com or tempeautorepairshop.com. That's tempeautorepairshop.com.
Arizona's news station. News station. KTAR. On air. 92.3 FM. Online at ktar.com. And streaming live on the KTAR News app. Your breaking news and traffic now.
KTAR News Time coming up on 11:30. I'm Mark Carlson. Pope Francis is in Dublin, Ireland. Today, the pontiff strayed from the scripted speeches planned for the World Meeting of Families and said the Catholic Church had much to be ashamed for in the sexual abuse scandals that have plagued the faith.
In his remarks, he said the failure of the church adequately to address these repugnant crimes, his words, has rightly given rise to outrage and remains a source of pain and shame for the Catholic community. This papal visit is a serious test of the famous Francis charm. He will at some point be meeting with survivors who tell us that they'll be listening not just for reassuring words, but also for real action.
That's ABC's David Wright reporting. The Pope is meeting with abuse survivors later today. Forecasters warn the tropical storm Lane is still a danger to Hawaii, even though it's no longer a hurricane. Heavy rains could still wallop the islands with flash flooding and landslides. Honolulu Mayor Kirk Caldwell says people need to be vigilant. Lane dumped nearly 3 feet of rain on parts of the Big Island of Hawaii over the past 2 days, forcing residents to flee their homes in waist-high water and officials to clear a series of landslides. Traffic and weather now. Here's Mike Daniels in the Valley Chevy Dealers Traffic Center.
Well, thanks, Mark. Some good news. That accident closed down the 10 westbound right between 51st and 67th Avenue. As cleared, all lanes now open. Now, we do have a wreck blocking the right lane 10 westbound at 35th Avenue. Police and fire on scene. Expect some delays there. And a crash on the 17 southbound Indian School Road right there. Crash off-ramp, not blocking. All lanes open in that area. This report brought to you by Smokey's Garage Door. Is your garage door squeaking, rattling, or just not working? The pros at Smokey's Garage Door will get you back on track fast. Free estimates and same-day service available. Just click SmokeysGarageDoor.com. I'm Mike Daniels, KTAR News.
KTAR weather for the valley today, partly cloudy with stray shower or thunderstorm possible. The high 101, 92 degrees in Glendale. Weather brought to you by Howard Air. I'm Mark Carlson on Arizona's news station, KTAR News.
Start your Monday morning with the latest breaking news, plus traffic and weather every 6 minutes on the Valley's only all-news morning show, Arizona's Morning News. Monday morning 5 till 9 on Arizona's news station, KTAR News, 92.3 FM, and streaming live on the KTAR News app.
Trust. It's hard to earn and sometimes even harder to find. If you live or work in downtown Phoenix, Matt Allen's Virginia Auto Service is celebrating over 20 years of award-winning service at the corner of 7th Street and Virginia. Recognized as one of the best service shops in the country, their customers have come to trust Virginia Auto Service for its A-plus rating by the BBB, two-year 24,000-mile warranties, and free transportation to and from your home or office. 20-plus years of earning your trust. Virginia Auto Service. They're serious about service.
Your family summer vacation awaits. Come experience the JW Marriott Desert Ridge Resort and Spa with a $50 resort credit to use towards golf, spa, or dining now through September 30th. Explore our expansive splash poolside bar, dining area, fire pits, flat screen TVs, and misting systems surrounding our lazy river, overlooking the Wildfire Golf Club's Faldo and Palmer golf courses for a stay and play you won't forget. Offer includes resort accommodations, $50 resort credit nightly, and kids eat free. Book online at jwdesertridge.com with booking code SPU.
Ouch! Being out of tune is no fun, and maybe even a little painful. Hi, this is Lee Weatherby, owner of Accurate Automotive in Mesa. At Accurate, we are a family-owned and operated one-stop automotive repair shop that specializes in building long-term relationships that are in tune with your needs, not ours. We've been recognized nationally as one of the top shops in the country, but for over 20 years, our priority has stayed focused on providing quality automotive service and repair at a fair price. I invite you to come in and see the difference an in-tune relationship can make for you and your car. With our free courtesy inspection, a $49 value, we feel it is well worth our investment in you because we believe good long-term relationships start early with your first walk through our doors. Accurate Automotive, home of friends serving friends, just off Broadway and Robson in Mesa since 1992. For more information, check us out online at accurateautomotiveaz.com today.
Trust here in the valley to repair your ride. This is Bumper to Bumper Radio, KTAR News on 92.3 FM.
Woo!
That's so annoying, especially when you do it.
I know, right?
Can't stand it.
Welcome back to Bumper Radio. I am Dave Riccio here along with Matt Allen, and we got Frank Lloyds from Desert Car Care in with us. And Matt, we got some texts. We've got Peter with an 08 Kia. We've got B-Tech George talking about teaching your teenager what the heck a smelly burnt oil smells like and the coolant leak smells like. And we've got Ken, Ellen, Dan, Johnny, and Lori on the phone. We're going to go with Dan in Mesa. He's got a 2006 Chevrolet Colorado. Hey, Dan, you're on Bumper to Bumper Radio. How can we help you?
I got a 2006, you know, Chevy Colorado. Thank you for taking my call.
You bet.
It's an automatic extended cab, and I'm driving. Everything's fine, and, like, I slow down and make a turn or pulling into the driveway, and it just flat dies.
So always do it when you want to make a turn?
The only time it usually does it is when I make a turn, or like if I'm coming off the freeway, when I get up and I stop at the light or whatever, if I make a quick stop, it dies.
Quick stop.
I can put it in neutral and it'll start right back up.
So what if you were just sitting there you stopped and it didn't stall, you weren't driving, you start the car up and you turn the wheel to the right or left, will it stall then?
No.
Okay. I was originally going to think maybe
it doesn't do it every time. That's the thing,
And then we have intermittent on top of that.
Yeah, intermittent on top of that.
You know what I was
doing? I had it in a shop, and the guy told me something about some kind of a actuator or solenoid or something.
Yeah, idle air motor. The idle air motor.
Okay, the idle air motor.
Yeah, there could be a number of different things going on. What I was originally thinking, they have a power steering pressure switch, and that's why I asked them about turns. When you're in the parking lot at low speed and you need to turn the wheel, that robs power from the engine. So there's a pressure sensor. It's going to sense that. It's going to send the signal back to the computer and maybe raise the RPM 100 RPM so you can actually turn the wheel. It'll give some extra power assist. Clearly, probably that's not the case. Maybe
idle speed control, idle air control, whatever you have on that engine that's responsible for maintaining that idle, especially under load as you steer, that's what we'd look at. As well as, if you've got a check engine light, that's a good baseline to kind of go into. One of the things I would look at, and perhaps he can do this very easily and safely, if he's got a vacuum sucking noise, he may not be hearing that in the cab, but a little slight nick in an air induction boot or snorkel could cause them. So we're getting more air into the engine. That's a possibility as well.
Yeah, carboned up throttle body, Dave. Yeah. I doubt a torque converter solenoid locking up on that. That's not symptomatic of that car. So, Dan, I guess it's one of those things where it needs to get to a shop. If you're looking for one, you're in Mesa. There's Mesa Auto Works. Frank, you're not too far from Mesa at
Lee Weatherby, Accurate Automotive out there.
If you have a shop, just go take that description in. That's one of those ones where I would probably plan on being without your car overnight, plan an overnight drop-off, and somebody's just going to have to take a look at it. But it's something to do with an idle control issue, and it's just a matter of digging in and finding it. That's just what somebody has to do.
For sure. Thanks for the call, Dan. 602-277-5827. We're going to go with Ken in Scottsdale. He's got a 2012 Lincoln MKZ hybrid. How can we help you, Ken? You're on Bumper Radio.
Good morning. Thanks for taking the call. Less about the car specific, but my car has about 118,400 miles on it. I've got a full covered, factory warranty to 125, and I've been waffling whether to start going towards a new car or not, but I think I might keep it and was looking at extended warranties. And are any of them worth the paper they're quote-unquote printed on?
That's a whole show topic.
Yeah, it is, for sure. There are good ones, and some people do well with them, and there are some really crummy ones, and some people really, by the end of it, hate the extended warranty company. Go ahead, Frank.
I think at the end of the day, you need to look at the timeline, the horizon of how long you're going to keep the vehicle. If we go back to the baseline of what is about 1,200 to 1,500 a year on average.
1,000. Miles.
$1,200 to $1,500 spent per year in car maintenance and some repairs. On average, that's about a number, right? Over 60,000 miles. Folks need to do the math. What's this extended warranty going to cost me based upon the timeline that I'm going to have it and those items that may not be covered? I'm more apt to believe not to buying something like that unless you're keeping it for some time. And then at that mileage, guys, I don't know what's going to be covered at 100K plus. There's really...
Yeah, you might have a hard time. I saw, interestingly enough, a woman came in for an oil change the other day, one of our customers who just doesn't drive very much. She just had to put some air in the tires. She'd only driven the car 1,000 miles in 6 months. There's no reason to change the oil. But she said, "What is this?" And she handed it to me. She handed me the backside, and it looked like an estimate. But, boy, this was an estimate for a computer, an engine, a transmission, and all this stuff, and it was $12,000. And then it had this, funny receipt over it that said, "No charge." Well, what they were implying when this was, when you then when you flip it over, it said, "Dear Miss Sally, you know, whatever your name is, we understand your car is coming out of warranty. Our records indicate," as if they have some records on
this
your
car. This is going to be a problem.
And so the implication is that they would cover $12,000 in repairs to your car. So I think those warranties are good at times. You have to get the right one. The other thing you can do, Ken, go to our website, bumpertobumperradio.com, and I think and I hope you can search warranty or extended warranty and find a podcast where we've talked about it. And I think, Dave, we should bring that up.
Or visit a garage. You know, we're in the pit day in and day out. We mess with these extended warranties, and I think a good garage is going to review that policy with you, make sure it's not.
Now, I know, like Geico, they have a good one that it's not an extended warranty, but they have mechanical breakdown coverage. So it's not extended warranty that covers anything, but if something fails in your car and breaks down that renders it undrivable, they'll cover it. That's an extra policy. CNA is another insurance company because that's really what you're buying is insurance. MPP is another one, but there's different types. There's the exclusionary type where it's covered no matter what unless you've told me it's not. So you've got to do a lot of shopping, and if it's on late-night television or an unsolicited phone call or mail, the answer is no.
If it's after the malt liquor advertisement, be careful.
For sure. Hey, good luck with that, Ken. You can also send us an email at bumpertobumperradio.com. Anyhow, let's go with let's go with Johnny in Surprise. He's got a 2008 Toyota Sienna. How can we help you, Johnny? You're on Bumper to Bumper Radio.
Oh, I appreciate the call, guys. I've got a 2008 Toyota Sienna that has seems like when I hit the gas under pressure, I get a little bit of a shudder out of it, and there's no lights on the car anywhere, nothing going on. It just shudders and acts like it wants to resist going forward, if you will, you know, and that's at 60, 70 miles an hour.
60, 70 miles an hour, that was going to be my question, what speed you're feeling that. So if you're cruising down the freeway and you're going 60 miles an hour, is this when you go to accelerate a little bit more because you want to get around somebody?
It is.
Okay. No lights. I wonder if he's starting to get a little bit of a misfire in there. That's kind of what I'm...
Yeah. Well, that's what I was wondering is, would a bad spark plug show up on my computer?
No.
It's not going to show up and say bad spark plug. If it was bad enough to cause a misfire and there was enough misfires that fit the parameters that Toyota wants to turn on the check engine light, then it could, but it's just not going to say, hey, you need spark plugs, Johnny. So,
okay,
but
170,000 miles on that transmission. I was worried about the transmission. Since you guys are transmission guys, I want to get your thoughts on that.
What you're describing to me is not a transmission issue necessarily, no. I wouldn't be guessing there. The first thing I'd be looking at is, you know, some sort of secondary ignition type of thing. You know, coils getting old.
Well, could have a coil. I was thinking an ignition coil could be breaking down. Doesn't always break down just sitting perfectly at idle under load.
So, yeah. I can't say the name. It's a very respected company that sells roadside service also. But they showed me a bill for like $4,000 worth of repairs for things that were worn. At 170,000 miles, I hope that something is wearing.
It's like a set of sneakers. They can have wear on the soles a day after you buy them. It doesn't make them bad. You know, and that's where the judgment's got to come in. But what you got going on probably more likely is a lean misfire. When you're up on the freeway like that, the computer has backed all the fuel out of the thing, so it's running nice and lean so you're not wasting, you know, gas. And it takes more ignition to fire a lean cylinder. So that's why I'm leaning that way.
Yeah, Johnny, and what you need to do, 170,000 miles, who knows who's worked on this, if you bought it new or if you bought it used. My suggestion is take all the service records you have, whether it's 5 records, or I had 70 pages a lady brought me the other day, 78 pages of service records. Get those and go through them and put them in chronological order. We don't care about anything at 30,000 miles. I'd say anything you have from 100,000 past, because we can save some diagnostic time. I mean, if this thing has the original spark plugs in it with 170,000 miles, we're starting with spark plugs. But if they were changed 40,000 miles ago with the right ones, we're not going there. We're looking somewhere else. So get your records together, and then back to that $4,000 list of things that were worn. You very well may need those things. But there's a difference between needing something, suggesting something, something really required to be done because it's safety. It sounds like you got the grocery list, and that's okay. But let's fix the problem first, and then when your problem's fixed, then we can decide how much that other quote-unquote worn stuff really is necessary. Like Dave said, I have a pair of shoes on right now. I've had them for 6 months. They're worn, but they don't need to be replaced.
No, they're still good. Yeah. So when we come back, it's, it looks like ladies segment. We got Lori, Lisa, and Ellen. We'll be right back. You're listening to Matt and Dave, your KTAR Car Guys on Bumper to Bumper Radio.
Hi, I'm Kurt Morgan, owner of Shadow Mountain Auto Service in Phoenix. I'm also a college automotive instructor, and I've been a technician for over 30 years. In that time, I've seen all kinds of games and gimmicks in the auto repair business, the worst of which seems to be associated with transmissions. I think it's because, to most, including technicians, the inside of a transmission is a mystery. So when one of our valued customers has a transmission problem, we send them straight to Tri-City Transmission. No games, no gimmicks. That's Tri-City Transmission.
There is nothing more important than family. Hi, Kurt Rock here for Kurt's Auto Repair. I brought my nephew and general manager, Jeff Rock, to help spread the word.
Thanks, Pops. Yep, the more things change, the more they stay the same at Kurt's. Family owned and operated, our ASE Master Techs and family ethics have earned us a perfect Better Business Bureau record for over 30 years. Just east of I-17 at 22nd Avenue and Bell, or online at mycarhurts.com.
Gas or diesel, foreign or domestic, if your car hurts, take it to Kurt's.
Hi, Kevin Rowe from I-17 Collision in Phoenix. If the bad news is you've had an accident, the good news is that with one easy click on bumpertobumperradio.com, you have the best collision, body, and paint shops to help you get back on the road quickly, safely, and with a repair you can trust.
Dave Lindgren here from First Class Auto Body in Scottsdale. Don't be fooled. Some insurance companies try to convince you that you must use their approved shops for your repairs. Not true. Arizona law allows you to choose the facility that's right for you.
And I'm Leo Petrozella from Campus Body Salon in Tempe. Having an accident is stressful enough. Dealing with the repair process shouldn't be. Appearance is important, but it's critical that structural integrity and safety are top priority.
Three convenient locations and one united team. With almost 120 years of experience and expertise between us, we are solely focused on taking care of you while working with your insurance company. The Collision Team at BumperToBumperRadio.com.
I said shake, rattle and roll. I said shake, rattle and roll. I said shake, rattle and roll.
Well, if
I said shake, rattle and roll.
If I could dance worth a damn, I might be grooving a little bit, but it's not happening. It might be kind of ugly, but so it's a good thing we're on the radio. So
I'd rather not see it.
Exactly. That's why I am not doing it. But it was my wife's birthday the other day, and she likes to salsa dance. And so I told her I'd get some lessons, and I'll start dancing. And, you know, if I get a couple margaritas in me, I think I can, you know, I'll get my
liquid
groove on.
Liquid courage.
Yeah, I'll get my groove on. So had that happen. And you had a birthday celebration I saw the other night, but you got something else going on today?
Yeah, we got, you know, in our household, everything is celebrated. Every day there's something going on. But really, my wife Josephine and I married 27 years this weekend. So
today's the day
time.
Or what?
Love you, honey. Just a big shout out. It's this weekend, so it's Sunday, tomorrow. So
very
we'll
good.
Be celebrating. Thank
27
you.
Years. Holy smokes. All right, so congratulations, Frank and Josephine. Wanted to get that out of the way. So we've got some phone calls to get through.
Let's get to Lori in Gilbert. She's got a 2012 Ford Fiesta. How can we help you, Lori? You're on Bumper to Bumper Radio.
Hi, thank you for taking my call. My question is regarding my air conditioning in my car. When I've had it to three different mechanics, and I get different scenarios all the time. So what it is that when my air conditioning runs for, say, 45 minutes to an hour, it stops blowing. It works fine any other time, but then it stops blowing. And I can turn it off to, say, for 10, 15 minutes, shut my car off, and then turn it back on, and it blows just fine again. So it's freezing. I've had the compressor fan replaced. I've had the compressor regulator replaced. I've had my radiator fan replaced. I've had Freon put in it. I've had another mechanic tell me that it could be my cabin filter in my cab, but I've had the other mechanic that I already took it to says that my car doesn't have a filter inside the cab. So my question is, what can I do to solve this? this, like I said, I've had it started three mechanics.
I don't, this one off the bat doesn't strike me as rocket science, you know, necessarily. What are you thinking, Frank?
So what happens is it just stops blowing. You lose the movement of air, correct?
Yes. Okay. And then in the past, when it's done that, I don't let it get that far anymore, but in the past when it does that, and then it will actually, when you drive down the road and it's off, it'll throw ice up on the windshield.
So there we go. There's a good clue. It's very humid out right now. It's freezing up. Frank?
Well, I could be wrong, but I would be looking at an ambient temp sensor possibly, shutting that system down depending on the vehicle. I heard volume of air, so that almost seems to be a game changer when we're talking about the frost. I mean, because that has nothing to do with the volume of air.
Well, maybe there's a low-pressure switch not cutting out. So you say, I used to have a 280Z, and that thing would blow when it was humid. It would like literally blow little snowflakes out the vent. It was so cold. But I'm thinking maybe we have a low-pressure switch. She says 45 minutes, right? Mm-hmm. Maybe the evaporator. See what happens there, Laura? You have to blow air over fins, and that changes. That's where you have your heat exchange from hot to cold. The hot air blows over a cold radiator, if you will, which is the evaporator, and you get your cold air. It's very humid right now. That humidity gets in there, and if that system is not cycling on and off like it should, and it's just staying on, that moisture that's on the evaporator can freeze that into a solid block of ice. That's going to restrict your airflow. And then once it shuts off for a little while, maybe the ice melts and then it blows again. So, but part of the problem is I've taken it to three different mechanics.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Find one shop.
That's qualified.
That's qualified and let them fix it. Don't go shop to shop because – I mean, we can have 10 different mechanics, 10, what is it, Dave? 10 mechanics.
10 mechanics, 8 answers, and 3 of them's right.
And 3 of them are right, yeah. So find one shop, unless they just creeped you out or they were horrible, but then go back to them and let them get the pattern so that they can see this and work on it. Don't chase the coupon. That's about the best.
And the other thing, too, is I think that also, again, this is going to be something people want to bring their cars and in within minutes they want an answer. On a problem like this, I'd want you to leave it with me for a couple of days because I'd run it for 45 minutes with a fan blowing across the condenser so I could make that thing do what she's, you know, I want to duplicate what's happening to her.
Or we got to have a technician drive it home because you don't want to pay my shop hour late to go have somebody go drive your car around for 45 minutes.
And in defense of her anxiety, I mean, she's obviously frustrated, is most good guys and gals that own these garages in these communities, you know, they're going to say, hey, listen, we've done our x-ray. This is what we're going to back up. This is what we know for sure. And if it does turn into some deeper surgical, this is where we start. I think a lot of her frustration is she's probably not going somewhere where they're actually fixing it properly. So, yeah.
Right. Yeah. Laura, you're in Gilbert. If you're looking for a good shop, you can do this with bumpertobumperradio.com. Let's go with Lisa in Mesa. She's got a 2013 Audi A7. How can we help you, Lisa? You're on Bumper to Bumper Radio.
Hi, guys. Thanks for taking my call, and I really appreciate your show.
Thank you.
So it's an intermittent problem, but it's like the initial startup of the Audi. I had like a thump, and earlier when you guys said, you should exchange cars with your spouse, and then you mentioned motor mounts, I'm like, oh, dear, I wonder if that what it could be, but it only has 40,000 miles on it.
Well, that doesn't necessarily mean anything with 40,000.
Okay.
But a motor mount won't typically make a noise or a thump until you do an engagement into gear, park or reverse.
Okay.
So is it only on the initial starting of the car you get the thump?
Yes, and it doesn't happen every time, and it's only like that initial startup after it sat overnight. It doesn't happen the rest of the time when I'm running around doing my errands or anything.
You know, my car, my Toyota truck, makes a funny noise sometimes, and I've noticed it since day one. So, but is this a new noise, or is this something that's kind of been there? You think it's
laughing on the radio when you said, and your wife said, this has been going on for a couple of years. So I'm like, okay, well, maybe I should find out
okay,
if I should take it in or not.
What I'm thinking, it might be completely normal. My Toyota truck has this weird noise after it's been running for about 30 seconds. It goes like a deep breath and goes, and there's just some kind of vacuum valve or something in there that's closing. What I'm thinking, she might start the car up and maybe it's electronic and maybe that's just one of the blend doors going flap.
Homing.
Going back to its home. And the blend doors are what divert air from hot to cold, or the dash or the floor or the defrost. It might just be a normal noise that's one of those vent doors just kind of landing back where it wants to go.
Yeah, no, for sure. And I don't think, you know, it's one of those, it sounds like it's a little bit intermittent. You know, it's one of those, you know, technician, if he hears it, like I say, we have a photographic memory, but for noises, you know, so he's going to hear it. He's going to know generally exactly what it is if he's been doing this for any length of time. I mean, some of these noises, they go, oh, that's just this or that or the other. So if we've got some experience. Now, sometimes, you know, someone hears right. something. And the one lady that talked about, I've been to three shops for this problem. You've talked to three different technicians, and they don't all have the same qualifications. I mean, that's one of the things with the shop hopping that we talk about is that, you know, this guy over here, maybe never went to class.
Or maybe she's talking to the service advisor who's getting some information, because she's talked about some parts that she replaced, and the words that she used, those parts don't exist. Yeah. So it's a little bit of lost in translation thing. And so it can be this is a difficult job to fix cars. There's so many moving pieces. I tease my wife, who's a physician. I said, hey, you got one model and two makes, and they've been the same since inception. We get new makes, we get new models, we get everything. And Ellen from Mesa, I am going to answer your phone call. We're not going to get you on the air, but we're going to take care of you.
Hey, Peter, on your Kia Spectra, I know you said the tires are new. I'm going to your text. I still think you got a tire problem. So go down, get those tires road force balanced. You can get that done at Desert Car Care if you want. Or, Matt, I know you got one of those at your shop.
Yep.
So, anyhow, we appreciate you joining us. Thanks, Keegan, for running the dials. If you're looking for a good, honest, competent shop, you can find them at bumpertobumperradio.com. While you're there, be sure to like Matt and I on Facebook. We'll see you next week.